Continuing our election coverage now, tonight we're looking at the high-profile race to replace Hennepin County Sheriff Dave Hutchinson, who is not seeking re-election after pleading guilty in a drunk driving accident that totaled his squad car.
Devon Rahming introduces us to the candidates and tells us why the election of either one will accomplish something that hasn't been done in 170 years.
The face of public safety for Hennepin County is about to change amid a race set to make a historic finish as the county votes to elect its first black sheriff, a first since the county was established in 1852.
Looking forward to this historic moment.
I've kind of done the first deal quite a bit. This is nothing new to me.
Both Joseph Banks and DeWanna Witt have a combined total of more than 40 years in law enforcement in various roles, they say making them the perfect fit for the county's top safety seat.
Are you from the state fair?
Let's start with DeWanna Witt, a wife, mother, and grandmother currently serving as a major in the department, overseeing the largest bureau, adult detention, and court services. What prompted you to want to run for Hennepin County Sheriff?
With everything that we see going on in the county, all the lack of trust, lack of accountability on all parts, I had a decision to make. Either I can run and do my best to make things better, or I can sit and do nothing. And
for Major Witt, this idea of better, she says, stems from her own personal lived experiences, having grown up on the south side of Minneapolis, becoming a mother at 15, and being a victim of crime.
It makes me more valuable.
What does better look like?
Trust. You know, we have nothing without trust. And in order to have that, we have to be able to meet people where they're at. We have to actually be able to collaborate with others to get us there, because there's no one person, no one community that is responsible. We're all in this.
Just a safe community.
Sentiments her challenger, an outsider, Joseph Banks, shares.
What sets you apart from her being an outsider?
Because I'm out here with the people, I hear what they're saying that needs to be fixed, and I want them to know that they have a voice that matters.
Banks, a former police chief, now a bail bondsman.
What about some of the programs we provide? What
is also the co-founder of Twin Cities Recovery, an organization assisting those struggling with substance abuse.
There is a definite need to look at how people got to the point where they're committing crimes.
Which is the driving force behind Banks' approach to public safety.
Nonpartisan, proactive patrolling.
Offering services to those in need while also using deputies to assist with patrols.
My biggest concern is that it's not just that we're short officers, but what are we doing with the officers that we have that could make a difference to try and fix the problem today? We got enough people to do the job. We need to reallocate those resources.
I'm the candidate for Hennepin County Sheriff.
I've heard.
A historic race. Both are aiming to finish with one goal.
My greatest dream is that people will be safe.
We don't have time to catch up. We need to keep our foot on the gas. High five, Jesse.
In Minneapolis, Devon Rahming, Care 11 News.
Over the summer, there were concerns raised over Witt's place of residence after she was seen in her county-issued car at her home in Dakota County. Witt says she still owns the home but moved to Minneapolis in April. State law requires candidates to maintain residence in their district for at least 30 days before the general election.